Right, game on. Okay, so we got humans versus woodies. I'm playing as the humans. Relatively well developed, few nice stats. Nobody's missing, so I've got 1700 team value. Going up against woodies. Defenders of the wild. So essentially it's man versus nature. Gained 70k in inducements, 80 in the bank. To bait. Just in case armor 8 doesn't do a thing. We'll roll with that. So this is a League of Gentlemen, small private league, pretty casual to be fair. Not unduly strict on rollovers and that. It's very accommodating. Not everyone's cup of tea. As the basically there's two main rules to follow. One is no fouling. Doesn't mean that you can't, you know, take kill skills or stack things like that, but there's no fouling, and there's no excessive touchdown delays, so end zone camping, things like that. There's nothing to say that you couldn't run up and instead of scoring on that player, pass to somebody else who'd score the next turn, things like that, you know. But we'll see how we get on. So Defenders of the Wild currently top. I've got offense. Yeah, they're top by a reasonable margin. Second game of Blood Bowl today. Had the had a decent game before, so perhaps I'm hoping to get a little bit of luck. I think I've got some of the right skills in the right places. Got some nice agility. So although I can't dodge like the elves, not too far being able to dodge with them. A couple of tackle pieces as well, so. Just want to get away from that tree as quick as possible. So I might just. Guard something I'm lacking. So I'd like to score on my catcher so he gets his next level. But both catchers, I'd like to score. Nicklin's kick, where's it going? Spread out to try and cover the frontage, so perhaps somewhere in the middle. First deep kick. On the opposite side to where he's stacked, but he gets to correct himself. It's a shame. So, yeah, he gets to put the tree on him. So that's my. Kick is now covered. So it's gone a bit more of a traditional setup, slight overhang on this side. Okay, so we just reached the ball. Then again, so we need to actually come back and cover it. There's the one. So therefore means we have to try and blitz this way. Not gonna follow that. Stun. Movements come back, so it takes me away from the tree. This is tackle. 1, 2, 3. So my agility one there, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Good. Left an obvious blitz target there because he's without skills. So what else? I got a stun out of that, but the kickoff event sort of changed my plan a little bit. So I'm going to target the Mighty Glow blitzer for a blitz. Wrestle, gets a pow. So that's made a gap through the middle. It's a hard break too. That's unfortunate. Okay. So already I'm under pressure. And then the catcher is... This is why Baz never levels, because he gets picked on. Hey! sort of gonna screen and split off. Split off my players, okay. There's a GFI. Punished for it. Does he re-roll it or does he not? He's gonna take a re-roll there. Okay, interesting. So we've got a re-roll off him, that's good news in the first turn. Interested to see where the tree goes. Would he GFI with a loner to tag these two out? Or would he just come across and tag? Doesn't do anything, takes no action, okay. Okay. Pushes then. So 2+ handoff here. I get. Oh, I need to come out here and cage. So let's climb the cage. Roddy is away from the, far away from the tree as possible. So we've got tackle here. Really want to knock the ball this way. Let's get the tackle there then. Okay, so we've got a little bit of pressure. So the tree's going. Okay, so just gonna get back over my last turn then. So, yeah, so he's gonna do the cage dive. He's gonna do the cage dive. He's got an agility up blitzer here. I mean, jump in, knock the ball this way. I mean, that's why I've got guard there. or he comes down here. That's a, so the reason I put catcher here is if he tries to blitz this way, at least I've got something, not much. And tackles in here for anyone trying to do anything this way. This guy here, the reason I moved him there was in case I snaked the handoff. At least there'd be potentially somebody by the ball, or maybe two people. Especially with an Aggie up War Dancer here. It would just be a gift to pick that up. Okay, so I'm gonna guess then that the blitz is gonna push towards the sideline. That's why these two are tagged out. Which also means the cage dive in through tackles, not really, so it's gonna be leap. That way he avoids guard. Okay, so just closing the net by the look of it. So we're looking at a 2 plus leap into a 1 die, and he has strip ball, so both down is what, both down or skull is what I'm hoping. It's the only way I can retain the ball. He's also sidestep as well, so. Or is he just going to blitz the side of the cage, potentially? Yes, okay. Alright, no cage dive. Blitz the side. Gets the pow. Okay, so. Doesn't follow. Comes back. So I'm guessing that Captain Greenpeace, he doesn't want to commit him to a cage because he is only 3 SPP away from his next level, so he's obviously the, not obviously, but I would suggest that he is potentially the target for for feeding the ball to. Overkill on tagging the ball. So if I put guard in here, that means I can hit him, and I could blitz this guy. so he's stunned. He can stand up and then he tags the cage. A bit stupid. Okay, so I've given up a free hit to the tree, but at least the guy has block, so there's always a risk chance of a 1 in 9. Fortunately, him sticking that guy in there has caused me a few problems. I mean, I didn't get the push back. Wouldn't have followed anyway, not with the ball carrier. So I see this side of the cage is perfect for a blitz, because then you get wrestle, got another pow. So, no armor break. So that's the blitz. Does kick guy stand up? Or does he stay down? Try and dodge out without dodge. Side steps, that's fine. Dodge away here, making 3 dice. 6, 7. He doesn't need it for 3 dice anyway, didn't see that guy there. Okay, so he decided to stand up, kick guy. Tree gets a 3 dice, then he gets a push, then the war dancer gets a 2nd hit. Oof, 3 pounds. Oof, this has not been good so far. He's followed that. Pinning myself in, frustrating my own play here. Okay, good, got one. Right. No long-term effect. Okay, so I can actually advance ever so slightly upfield now. Ha 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 ha! Tree busy, so we can't come in. Let's see if we can make a dodge. We can't. It's a one. So at least we get a scoring threat up the top. That's one of the things I can move. Right, so we've managed to remove one. So at least I'm forcing the dodge here if he wants to get his strip ball guy. Won't be much, but protected this tackle. Tied up the tree. So he can get two dice in this way. Maybe I shouldn't have gone that far. Never mind. Okay. So I've left two dice on my block piece. Got my guard in here as well to try and protect these guys. Okay, so that's going to tie them up. So I get a tackle hit on him because he doesn't blitz me. So he can come in. Doesn't pop dogs because he's going to go for a cage. Dodge. He's jumping in, but he's got. Oof, unlucky. Okay, so there's the reroll. I don't have short hands, he just needs to push. It's a snake. That is unlucky. That is unlucky. Okay. Sidestepping Roger there, so ideally I'd like to get three dice on that. Okay, so we're just gonna get pushes. That's the time to get dub skulls before I make the blitz. Three dice with tackle. Good. Follow that. Okay, so he's the threat. He has tackle, so. Take the score, take the level. Right, okay, so we've leveled him so he can go off and take a rest. Don't know why Blitzer would be on there. Right. Who's on the bench? One catcher. My rookie throw, okay, so. Didn't mean to do that, get off, thank you. Okay, so I've got. Right, okay, so. So I've got my strongest players on the pitch. I'm taking off my agility, but then again, I've got two agi ups, but I've taken my dodge players off. So. One block on the LOS, two rookies. Imagine. No kick for me. Oh, he scuffed it. No, go on, do that. So if he goes there, he tags two out, doesn't he? That make a difference? One, two. One, two. Still tag two, doesn't matter how I do it. Three on the LOS. Don't have any sure hands. Oh no, dude, look at him. What am I about? So. Let's bring him back on. Okay, so the ball went backwards anyway. Okay, so the tree did pretty much what I thought he was going to do, but just in a slightly different place, which is fair enough. So that if I can get Barry to dodge away with the dodge skill, be a 1 in 9 to fail, but at least then that would just leave a rookie Lino stuck to the tree, which could be a good thing, or it could be a mighty blow perm. But that's what he's there for. Okay, so looking for the two dice, going that way to push him towards the sideline, makes sense, yeah. Gets the pile, so he can go with my scoring threat, because he's the first one up the pitch. So that's a block plus block there when he takes that on his last re-roll, so do you want that for the pickup in case it's a 1? So getting behind the tree for the capture. Got the ball. Hand off back into a cage. Ball is safe, he's blitzed, so just needs to complete the back corner of the cage if he wants. And then take a block here. Nice hit there. Nice power. Okay, so I've got an option on the tree. Okay, so I've got one die on the tree. I'll try it. It's got to be a reroll. And it's successful. Come on, mighty blow. Yes! Result! Probably should have dropped those guys back, actually, my bad. riding high on the success of knocking the tree down. It cost me a reroll. Okay, so he's pretty tied up over here. Can easily dodge away. I haven't got any tackle on any of these dodge pieces, so it's just a push there. Okay, so that's the first time we've not had a knockdown. Followed it. That needed to be a knockdown, really, I think, to allow him to swing round. So he's going to have to commit more. Okay, so he's got the knockdown. That opens up the side quite a bit, actually. So looking at a side cage, and then he was flood all of his elves through. They've all got dodge. Okay, so it's going to be a sideline cage. So if any of these is a snake. So one dice at the minute, that makes it a two. Okay, so rather than completing the cage, side cage, we're going for a 1 in 9. So I will have to re-roll that. Okay, so I've got the last re-roll off him. Rewarded with an armor break as well. Okay, so a mistake there that's been rewarded. He's stunned, so it doesn't matter. So we've got two sidesteppers. We can score quite easily. So another GFI post reroll. Got him. Right, good. Back time. So that Greed's reroll has so don't roll the one there. To the point. Right. Back. So I need to hit him with tackle, really. Got any skills that are really going to help me, but at least if I bring him back, he's doing something. Okay, so we've got a KO. Kick guy's KO, so that may. Okay, so re-roll that. Little sidestep out. I have to follow that so I can get tackle on the ball. Alright, so we've got one piece left. The tree's not a concern, so. He doesn't have guard. I've got guard in there, so he isn't going to be able to get two dice on him. So getting tackle away is going to be very difficult. That said, I think this is where I'm weakest. So I don't like. I mean. We come round here, we blitz him out the way, we make a dodge away from tackle here, which is a 2+, doesn't have a reroll, but that guy is a scoring threat if he rolls a few dice. Try that. Probably not the best. Okay, so you've burnt the one. Fair one. Should be able to make the dodge now. Okay. So two dice against dodge. Any failed action gives me a chance to stop a score on this drive. That was a snake then, with that first one. Oh wow. Okay, that's really unlucky. That is really unlucky. At least he's still alive, he's still on the pitch. So yeah. Okay, so he's got one turn left. Scoring threat is the catcher, the war dancer, and that guy over there. Okay, so let's. Where's the ball going? The ball's going out. Okay, so we get tackle on this guy. Take that. Okay, so he's no longer a scoring threat. mighty blow hit on the War Dancer. We're gonna stay. Get a KO. Okay, so we definitely can't score. We can't score, but neither can I, so. Right. So what can I do? Where have I messed up and given blocks and double power? Speak too soon. Okay, so he's getting walloped. But he's okay. Where's the blitz? Okay, so yeah. So we've left a blitz on TL with no defensive skills. Hip skull camera action. Yeah, just asking for pows and removals really by doing all that. There's no need to do that at all. That was completely idiotic end to the half there. I gave away definitely one more block than I should have. Greta Thornburg would be well pissed off right now because it's humans putting one over on nature at the moment. Okay, so just one KO back. Okay. Alright, I'm back in defense. Does he commit another one to the line? So he can go back to getting three dice? I suppose he's not this guy anyway. Okay, so out of War Dancer, out of Catcher, out of Lino. I get a free turn. I can't reach the ball. Oh, it's a one. Okay. Fair's fair. If I get a blitz, he gets a one. Let's see what we can get out of this. Must be that. So we've got a bonehead. Okay. had a blitz in the last game as well, but it came on my turn 16, so it wasn't overly effective since I'd set up at the back. Right, the tree is unleashed. So he goes there. Okay, so that's going to allow him to punch a hole through there as long as he gets knockdowns. She's got one out of two so far. Blockless on blockless. He's nabbed it. Okay. So is this going to be the blitz? Who are you going to blitz with? Blockless against? So you're looking for another 33% chance of getting a knockdown there. No, my bad, not 33. I'm talking nonsense, aren't I? So you've got a 55% chance to hit me down. Which is very doable. Surprisingly, Baz does not get his armor broken. It's a shame that Ogre decided to bonehead, because if I could have got in there, that would have put guard and tied up that entire option. Would have been a lot more unlikely, should we say. But I mean, if you're going to roll POWs, then it doesn't matter. Okay, so off we go. Got the ball. We've got 2 plus, nice and easy. So we're coming through here to stop. So kick could dodge through and become a scoring threat down that flank. So we've got a catcher. So yeah, okay, so we've got a scoring threat coming down. Okay, well, not overly worried about that. Not worried about that. Okay. Okay, so we didn't bonehead. Right. Now it's a GFI, we don't want that. It's a bit disappointing. We have to follow that. Chasing a pow here. Oh, okay, I've got it. skull, man. Come on. Damn. Leave me alone. But never mind. Would be the guy with block, wouldn't it? Never mind. So that all started to go wrong when I failed to get a 75% block on the guy with kick. From that point, that tied up all these players here. I wasn't going to reroll that. Yes, I got a nice pow on the catcher, which was fortunate, but that failed dodge into casualty is a little disappointing. Luckily, I've got bench, which will be calling on the reserve soon. Right, retreat and tie up quite a few players here if he moves. I'm gonna go this way and tie up these two. Yeah. So I'm very exposed down the flank. The thing is, the drama I've got is because I couldn't free up these two guys, that means he can easily side cage, which I'm gonna have a lot of trouble with. So I've got any tackles. So there's another block there, which means he'll block there when he rolls his powers. Yeah, and then block back. Push to here, perhaps. Okay. So we're gonna. So we're blitzing back. Oh, at least I forced him to blitz back. Okay. Block dice are very potent at the moment against me. Right, so we've got a last block here. I'd like pushes, that'd be favourable. Not gonna happen, is it? Okay. That is unfortunate for me. Naked. That's right. Don't bone it. Come on. Oh, you bugger. Ah. Thank you, there we go. Oh, why did you have to bonehead? I needed guard in there. Absolutely needed guard in there right then. Yet again, man. Oh. potentially he might have to blitz this guy off. Which is very easily done. Don't really want to leave a guy on the tree, but if I do that, at least the tree can't come down here. Tackle's back here, I've got a tackle here, got a massive gap here because he's boneheaded, so we can easily create a gap through here, so I need to plug this gap. I have to just let that guy get hit by the tree. He fails the dodge. Tree's freed up to come and be a nuisance. Okay, so we've got blockless blocks to push him onto the tree. We're gonna have to burn a reroll there. And he's a 1 in 9. Oh dear. Okay, so Bruce Wayne has KO'd himself. And he's KO'd me too. Okay. So fair's fair, I guess. Right, okay, so got a KO from the Sir, that's useful. What are my options on the ball? I can't get tackle on him. I get a one die with block. Can I make it two dice by blitz? He's a sidestepper, so I'm chasing a pow. Well, no, I'm not actually, no, because I've got tackle, so. Okay, so if he steps towards the catcher, he's got a chance that he can catch it. I've used my blitz. Or he goes back. I've got a stun out of it. Got a good scatter. Chance picking the ball up. Does that make sense to go there? One square too far back to my liking. I like that a little bit better, so let's try that. So we pop dodge, can we not one in nine? Dodge is gone. Oh, come on. I have to re-roll that. That was very unfortunate, but so there's had to be a one in there somewhere. Okay, so I'm a bit vulnerable now. There's a scoring threat here once he stands up and moves down the pitch. This guy is not tagged, but he is not agility up. The only real saving grace I've got is the Agi up War Dancer is stunned for this turn. The tree cannot come over here to be a nuisance, but when he blocks this way, he then ties up the ogre. This guy has Wrestle, so... Okay, so he's taken a dodge. So the question is, how are you going to get two dice there? You can get two dice to Wrestle. Okay, so Wrestle Blitz there. If that doesn't work, it comes this way. You've got to come right round with the capture. Okay, so you're going to push on to the ball, I think. Okay, he's got the plow. Let's get onto the ball. An arm. He always gets an arm break. Baz is not very good. Come on, catch. I like it. Big fan of that. So, flood everybody around him now because he's stunned. Okay. Got a reroll. Gonna use it. Down to his last reroll, but then again, so am I. So the scoring threat is going to come down the field, okay. Takes the blocks, gets the blocks. Aaron, you did your job, unfortunately. And now you can pay for it. Right. So he's stunned, the ogre is tied up. Got to dodge away from the tackle. Makes it. Makes it indeed he do. Make it away, come on. High roll, please. Oh, no, no, sorry, I messed that up. It's a one as well. Never mind. Oh, why can you catch that? No, never mind. That's my bad. I completely forgot about diving tackle. So I scuffed that for myself there. I've turned what could have been a winning opportunity into what is most likely going to be a draw because I'm an idiot. Never mind. Never mind. Live and learn. Shouldn't have even re-rolled that, really, should I? Because I needed, like... So we've wrestled him to the ground. means it's a 2+ on the ball to get it to this guy who can then score. Why didn't I pay more attention? How would I have done that if I'd spotted that? I mean, he's a sidestepper. Could I have changed the blitz? Yeah, I would have had to, but that's why you, that's why you brought that guy there. So, it's my bad. Okay, so what are we looking at? 2+, 2+. Oh, okay, so I've got the reroll off him. Last reroll is gone. It's a snake. No, it's not going to be a snake. Oh, that was. Okay. This is anyone's game then. However, that was unlucky. What I did was just stupid the turn before. So I deserved... I got away with that massively there. I completely deserve to get punished for that. Where he's diving tackling now, he's up there. So I don't have a reroll. So we're looking for a knockdown. Get it. We follow that. Mighty blow doesn't work. I'm gonna go there. That's why I used it. Now don't be a 1 in 9. I knew there was a 1 coming there, so instead of dodging my agi up guys. Didn't need to use break tackle. Okay, so I've given him 2 dice to clear Nick out of the way. Clears Nick out of the way, then he's got a 4+ pickup. Because he's in 2 tackle zones. Then he's got tackle there. So, unless he takes the 1 dice there and then he blitzes. We can dodge through to there. So, follow this guy up. This is a 1 in 9. He hasn't stood the kick guy up yet. Okay, loving little fat pound for Nick. Scatter the ball. It's been the same tactical game. Hopefully Nick is alright and stays there. Okay, so it makes no difference. The ball is still in 2 tackle zones. I've been lucky on the scatter. Glad it didn't go the other way. Right, so should nobody apart from the kick guy can reach this now. No, I tell lies, sorry, no, my bad. War Dancer can reach, but he'd have to dodge out through tackle, or he'd have to leap, dodge, and then dodge into tackle. So ball is relatively safe, considering I'm playing Wood Elves. So if he dodges out this way, so 2 plus, 2 plus, 2 plus, and then doesn't have to do tackle, and then he could leap onto the ball, pick it up on a 3. And if this guy was to make a dodge beforehand, he could pass, maybe? What about the catcher? Is he a threat? So he could come out around and tag this guy. He's blodged diving tackle because I've blinked, much to my mistake. So he's going to cut the corner. Right, so it's all good. Okay, so are we looking at this as the blitz then? Dodge out, blitz here, is that? Or are we going to leap and blitz this guy off? And then pick up on a 3. Okay, so the leap's good. Come on, both down. Pushes, I love it. So. So, that would have to be a big ass shorty to dodge into there. Or is he just going to tag the ball up? Pushes, okay. Will he follow or stay? He's gonna follow, okay. So we're gonna dodge out or are we gonna take an uphill? I've got no rerolls. So the first thing that goes wrong. Need a removal here really, because this guy is just too much of a nuisance. Stay. Okay, that is really gonna help, that's great. Okay, that is great news. I knew it was coming. I knew it was coming. Absolutely knew it. So it would have been a snake on the dodge, it would have been a snake on the pickup. Okay, so he's got a dodge out there. Tackle is in completely useless place. He can get 2 dice on the catcher, followed by 2 dice on him. Only thing I've got going for me is when he scatters this guy onto here, is that it doesn't bounce somewhere, really easy for him to pick it up. So I mean, tag the thrower, blockless block on him, allows him to pick that up, leap out. He doesn't have dodge, he does, so that guy's basically free. Is it going to be another Dub Skulls coming? Is it going to be a 1 in 81? Try that the reroll. Boom, there we go. Oh, he's leveled. It's only taken him about 12 games and sat on that SPP for a long time. Why did it have to be a one man? The simplest actions. So he can't score. He can't score. He can, as long as he can get to the ball. He's got no re-rolls. I've got tackle next to the ball. Right. So we blitz out this way. Success, dodge. It's just a push, that's successful. So now tackle's over here. Follows, so if you dodge through, ooh, it's a lot of dice still. And then two GFIs without a reroll. That's a lot of dice without a reroll. Gonna want it. Nice, well done. So I don't have any movement patching, it's only the gates, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So I need 3 pushes somehow. Oh, whatever, let's just play it. Where's his kick guy? Oh, my bad. to reroll. Oof, he's almost level. Not bad, not bad. Let's have a look then. So, 28 pounds. Yeah, even on that, that's good. I had a few more skulls, but I think I rolled a few more dice, so. A few more pushes. What do we get? Even ball possession, really. I went for a pass. Few more blocks, yeah, I've got more KOs than that. Nice little game. Oh, right, I'm gonna leave it there. That's two games of Blood Bowl for me today. That's all of my league games done for the weekend. Because I can't play them in the week at the moment with the Wi-Fi I've got, but not too bad. So I had a nasty loss yesterday. Had a win with Underworld earlier, and then obviously a draw. So, one of each type. I messed that one up. That diving tackle was idiotic. I wasn't paying attention. And that cost me the chance to potentially break away up the pitch there for maybe a 2-0 score. So, I can only blame myself for that. And I'm not sure what the odds would have been without a reroll. On Samba for that equalising play, but it was well deserved. And then hopefully I look forward to playing against Uniball again in the League of Gentlemen. Right, but that'll do me for now. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you again.